activities, we give God all the glory. Amen? Amen. Where is Isaac? Didn't you just lead worship? So you put down your guitar and you vacated your position, and there you are in the back, still hanging out. That's pretty good, isn't it? I love the way that I watched you slip out of yourself into the Spirit. I just, that is such a wonderful gift to be able to lay yourself down and to let the Spirit of God lay hold of you. And it was amazing to watch how he would minister through you. On the second song that you sang, you led, what was the name of it?
Praises.
The ministering angels came into the building, and the atmosphere completely changed in the house as you were leading. And the gifts of healing, that was so wonderful that Pastor just picked it right up and said, okay, we're going to just press into this a little more. But what was happening while you were singing, leading that song with the rest of them, is the ministering angels were releasing healing. And we had every opportunity during that time, as we listened to the mood of the Spirit, we, to get healed. And God was using you as his tool to accomplish his purpose. So in your ministry, there'll be many times. And I just want to pray for you that God will open your eyes so that you can see the angels, the ministering angels, as they coming in. But there's also a place that God's called you to do war against the enemy with your music. And it's my heart's desire that you recognize those moments so that he has no opportunity to speak whatsoever to anyone in the house. Because God has gifted you and anointed you not only to lead worship, not only as a worshiper, but to teach others how to step in to the atmosphere, the mood, the comeliness of God. So I'm going to lay hands on you if that's all right with you. So, Lord, I bless him. And I just say thank you, Lord, in this blessing, Father, that you're releasing, that his eyes would be open to see more than he's ever seen before. That as he concentrates, Lord, lends himself to you, that he would see the happenings that are going on. And then as he leads the worship, he'll begin to call out, to sing out the happenings that are going on. That as he sees, Lord, the different ways that you're healing, that he'll be able to release that by prophesying, speaking it forth, calling it out, Lord Jesus. And I pray for a trumpeting voice for him, Lord. I release a trumpeting voice in this man to break the strongholds of the enemy during the times of praise and worship. And so we give you praise. We honor you, Lord Jesus, with this. And Father God, I pray for a hedge of protection around him. I ask, Lord, that you would secure him. Lord, that you would secure what you've called him to be. And all that he is to be, that, Lord, there would be such protection. But I pray for the night watches for him, Lord, that he learns the new song in the night watches. And that, Lord, as he sings that, that the miraculous would begin to happen. So I bless my brother Isaac to that, Father God. And I say, come forth in the name of Jesus, the riches of the deposit of the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, and this man in Jesus' name. Amen? Amen.
Go for it, brother. Go for it.
Yeah. Yeah. Good stuff. Oh, my gosh. Where's the drummer? Right there. I saw you. I watched you. Can I hold your hand? Thank you. I watched you. You know, do you know what a prophetic drummer is? You are. You are. So there's going to be times when, along with the worship leader, that you're just let loose to do the prophetic work on the drums that breaks the stronghold of the enemy. And it will be so beautiful in your spirit, but it'll be so absolutely powerful that you break the strongholds in people's life when you start to move on those prophetic drums. And I'm going to encourage you, almost a command, but I can't command you, but I would if I could, to practice that prophetic gifting that you have in those drums. Because you're going to hear sounds that you've never heard before. You're going to have help from the host of heaven to bring forth what God is wanting to do in the house. And it's going to be sometimes like thunder that just absolutely changes the atmosphere, that totally begins to move against the enemy's wiles. And people's minds will be healed because you've broken the strongholds in their life by the prophetic drum. God will enlarge your territory in such a way you're not going to become big-headed about it at all. I promise you that, because God's going to hold you steady, because the word is going to be life to you that finds it. And as you begin to read the word in different, under the guidance of the Holy Spirit in a different way, he'll show you how to move in that rhythm of his. And the rhythm of heaven is a lot different than the rhythm here when it comes to the prophetic drum. So I want to bless you to receive the rhythm of heaven, so that strongholds can be broken. But in that, when the strongholds are broken, there'll be a sound that comes that brings healing. It's going to be amazing. So I bless you. So Father, I ask in Jesus' name that you prepare his heart, that you anoint these hands, that Father God, you'd give him courage to encourage. You'd give him strength to endure. That Father, you would fasten the truth and the power of the prophetic to him. And we'll just give you all the glory for it in Jesus' name. Amen. You know, in the heavenlies, the sounds that are in the heavenlies, and I'll just release this real quickly, the sounds in the heavenlies are a lot different than our sounds here. But God is going to release in the days ahead to those that can hear and will hear and are asking to hear, they're going to hear those sounds. And some of it is not going to be pleasing to those who do not want change. But God is a God of change. And he's going to make large changes this year, next year, and the following year. And some of us are going to cringe because we're saying, I'm so comfortable. And to use my language, just get over yourself. And get on with God's business. We do not have the right to stay in one position. We are forever moving into greater revelation, greater understanding, greater wisdom, greater knowledge about what God's doing. And he doesn't want a stale body of Christ. Because when we grow stale, we stink. And that's fact. So God is calling us to be ready to move with him, just to be able to increase in all that he's calling us to increase. And we are all different, and that's the beauty of the body of Christ, that we're all different. That's the wonder of God, to be able to raise up wonderful people that are a facet of who he is. And when he puts all of those facets together, it is lovely to behold. But he's dealing with us that have been afraid or timid or waiting for a sign to fall out of heaven to move. He wants us to hear his voice. He wants us to know what he's doing. He wants us to pursue what he's doing. So the pursuit is on if we're willing. I understand that this is a hungry group. I'm not sure what you're all hungry for, but you're not sure what you're hungry for either. You're just hungry. So gimme, gimme, gimme. But he's called us to give, give, give. That's what he's called us.
Water.
All day I face the barren waste, huh? Yeah. Oh, you Westerners know what that song is. Yeah. Come alive. The enemy's not liking what we're saying. But he has no power.
Excuse me.
So God's going to move. Are you? All right, you just made a declaration and God heard it. You just said yes, and he heard that. I love you, Glenn. Everybody needs to love Glenn. He's a man that can blow the shofar and cause the atmosphere to change. He's a man that called in the lost on the four corners of our church. God used him in a mighty way years ago to blow the shofar and cause the enemy to be scattered and invited the host of heaven to come in. God is good that way. So pick up that shofar that you've laid down for a little while and begin to use it for the glory of God. Because wherever he is sending you to, they need that instrument because it's an instrument of God. So I bless you in that. And you always had such joy. But you know what? God is redeeming the joy. That we're, there's hard places, and I haven't seen you in a long time, but I know there's hard places. And God's redeeming your joy. And he's setting you free to dance again. And I saw you jumping, but you're going to dance. I bless that to you, Glenn. I love you. He's a son. He's a son. So did I change subjects? Yes. Yes. Because God uses some of us to just meet the needs of people in the congregation and not just bring a teaching's never a just. But he uses us all differently. Where's that little curly-haired woman that I saw a while ago? Where'd she go? I saw her in the spirit and I saw her in here a while ago. There she is. Do you want to hold that for me? Thank you. I'll be back for it. I'm coming to you, honey. Surprise. I was praying, and I get pictures of people that God wants to speak to, and he wants to speak to you. Don't stop doing. Start running, because he's giving you new shoes to run in, and they're going to be comfortable shoes to run in. And where things have been a little bit like climbing uphill instead of going straight, God's even going to give you shoes that will help you climb the hills in a way that are not taxing on your body. And God's going to heal your back. It's already moving, but that's going to be completed. And the joints in your hand, your different joints. God's going to heal all of those joints so that you'll be loose-jointed. What did I mean by that? You're going to be loose-jointed. Anybody that's, I'm touching you. Anybody, on purpose. Anybody that is, God is calling to be loose-jointed means you're going to be able to reach a multitude of people. A multitude. It may be in the marketplace, and it will be. It may be in your occupation, whatever that is. It may be in many different ways. But yeah, the teaching gift that you've craved is there. And it's going to be released and then released. You're sweet. And then released and released. Yeah. So in that, ask God to show you what the new shoes look like. And he'll give you a dream. And he'll give you a vision in the dream, and then you will have instruction. So I bless that to you. Amen? Amen. You really are sweet. Yes, she is. She's really, you're full of mercy. And you're full of compassion. And you just love people. Yeah, God's going to use you mightily in deliverance. Because you have compassion. And that's how he heals, is by the spirit of compassion. That's the gifting that God is releasing in a greater way in you. It's there, but he's stirring it up and releasing it in a greater way. And where at times you thought you were not very significant, God says in his heart, you're mighty, and you're powerful, and you're wonderful, and you will pull down strongholds. You will. I see, when I'm looking at you, I see a hearing ear. You know, your ears are about this big. I mean, they're not really. But looking at you in the spirit, you have these great ears that hears. And you're going to hear the very softest times that God speaks. And you're going to hear the very loudest times that he speaks. But you're an intercessor, so God is calling you to a deeper place in that, because he's going to reveal his secrets to you in the days that are ahead. And you will stand in the gap, and things will change because you're praying. So I bless that to you in Jesus' name. Amen? Amen. I know you do. Thank you, Mr. Glenn. Yeah. Isn't God good to us? I really did bring a teaching about being hungry. But you're not really here for that. That's not what you're here for. Yeah. So tell the Lord right now, what do you want to be and to do? What do you want to be? What is your want to be? Just think about it for a moment. And then ask the Lord what he's called you to be. Our wannabes are not always what we're called to be. But oftentimes, our wannabes are exactly what he's calling us to be. So we need confirmation sometimes, don't we? About what is it? Are you really ready to spend yourself? Are you really ready to spend yourself? Because that's the cost of being what he wants you to be, is to spend yourself in the kingdom. It's pretty inconvenient, I'll tell you for sure, to spend yourself. But it's marvelous. And you will not know all the things that's being accomplished when you're ready to spend yourself. Isn't that right, sir? To give yourself fully. And sometimes God's like pressure on us. It's just, you can just feel his weight come in, and it's good, but it feels heavy sometimes. Like, I can't do that. That's too much. And God says, nothing is impossible. God says to you, nothing is impossible with him. Nothing is impossible with him. Nothing. Would you say that with me? Nothing. He's called me to do the impossible. And he's going to take me into new territory. And he will reveal his purposes to me. And I will follow what he's leading me to do without hesitation. Without hesitation. I am his servant. And I give myself. fully to his expression. Take a breath, everybody. One more. You'll get there. One more. You just breathed out the old. And you're walking in the new. And you will welcome his visitations. And you will hear his voice. And you will respond. Because God has given you a key to open doors. And you will recognize when you turn that key that that's the right door to open. And you will not fear what's on the other side of the door. Take a breath. Yeah. God's playing with him just a little bit. Yeah. He's also being healed. That's what's so magnificent about this, is he's being healed. All your yesterdays are gone. There's today. It's a new day. It's a new day.
Uh-oh.
Come with me for a moment. Just walk with me for a moment. We're going to walk down here. We're going to strengthen this. See what's happening? Just keep walking with me. Just keep walking with me. Oh. You want to lay hands on this young man? That's all you have to do.
Don't twist his head off just like that.
Take a breath, son. Let it come. You can have another breath. Do you know this man?
Yes, he does.
Oh, he does. Is that why he's wondering what you're going to do? Can he put his hand on your chest? Can he put? You! Yeah. Yeah. Just close your eyes for a moment. Actually, he's going to release the Father's blessing just by putting his hand on you. It's not necessarily something that he's going to pray, but he's releasing a Father's blessing. Because the Father wants to bless you. The Father wants to encourage you. The Father wants you built up strong in the Spirit. Released to do mighty exploits in his name, to wear the warrior's bonnet. Yeah. He wants to heal yesterday's sorrow and bring in today's joy. Yeah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Can I touch your cheek? Yeah. There you go. I bless you, son. Excuse me. Come with me.
I forgot to ask permission. Can I do this? Go, go, go. Just don't come there. We're going this way. See how wonderful it is just to be able to move, be moved by the Spirit, to be able to yeah, you know what? Stop. Stop, go. Could he put his hand on you? Could you stand up, please? Mm-hmm. We all know who she is, but this is okay. Just your hand. That's it. Take a breath. Breathe. 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 Ooh. What? So, one more deep breath. Whoa. Yeah. Yeah. She needed refresh, and that's what's happening. That's what's happening. It's that refreshing that God brings, and the way that joy just comes. And it just ministers to us. Yeah. One more deep breath. Are you refreshed? Good. 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 Yeah. It's not just this moment that God is refreshing you, because he's bringing a spirit of refreshment. And you're going to deposit that as you lay hands on others, is that place of refreshing. I'm going to catch the next one. That's what's going to happen. So, how many of you are refreshed a little bit more than when you came in? Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, certainly, certainly you can. You want to still walk with me? Yeah. Isn't it nice that, you know, you can just walk around and give directions and say, go that way, young man. Just go. Do you see this young man right here? Do you know him? Oh. Did we get your name? You know, if I was to hand him the mic, you don't know what would happen. There would be some real changes in here. So, God has so much more for you in the days. Could you stand, please? Thank you. Could you put your hand in the... See that hand right there?
Yes.
Can you put it? Please turn around this way. This way. Just put your, no, no, right there.
All right.
Actually, it's all teaching to see what God is doing and where your hand will do what God wants it to do. And so there's healing being released right now in his whole spine.
and in his lower back, God is inviting him to receive healing in that place. And God's inviting him to receive healing in his legs where he won't tire as quickly as he has in the past, and where he won't feel like he has kinks and clinks, but where God is wanting to do this work of refreshing. So God wants to heal his joints, in his hands. You can hold his hand. He wants to heal the joints in his hand. Yeah. So Lord, I ask for the fire of healing to rest on my brother. That even as Pastor said earlier, those things are being healed. But Lord, we're asking for the more. For the more, Lord. That whatever he receives, he'll give away. However you touch him, that's going to be what he's going to deposit for others. But Lord, I pray that you would bring a spirit of encouragement on my brother. That Father, you would speak to him in such a way that he would know that he knows how wonderful he is in your sight, how much you have ordained for him to walk in, how many people that you have set up for him to touch, to bring the word of wisdom, the word of knowledge to speak into their spirit. How many young men, Lord, that you've set up for him to say, walk this way into the fullness of Christ, into the knowledge of Christ, into that pleasant place with Christ. Yeah. Lord, just go deeper. Don't let any hindrance stop him from receiving the more that you have for him. Lord, would you heal his eyes? Would you touch his eyesight, Lord, so that he sees deep into the Spirit? Would you touch his tongue, Lord? That would be a tongue of knowledge, a tongue that brings healing and encouragement and hope. And Lord, would you bless him? I'm going to touch your forehead with a greater release of hope. Go deep, Lord. Expand him, Lord. Fill him, Lord. And we'll just give you praise for it. I bless you. I bless you in Jesus' name. I just want to share something. Oftentimes you'll minister and people fall, but don't lose me. God is in the business. So many people want to be taken out in the spirit, but God is teaching the body to stand. It's easy. It's easy just to walk in and let people be touched and to fall out in the spirit. But that's not what God's doing right now. Even though that would happen, that's not what he's doing right now. What he's doing is saying, I want my people to stand. I want them to use their feet to stand on, because I'm going to hold them steady, and I'm going to be their strength, and I'm going to use them to change the world as they're willing. But it's this attitude of give me, make me feel good. And the walk in the Spirit is not always a feel-good thing. It's not always that. It's costly. But he wants you buff. He wants to see some spiritual muscle. And you are growing older, because we're growing older every day. But you know, the Holy Spirit's in the same age in every one of us. Do you know that? Take a breath. God is washing. Take another breath. Yeah. 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 I promise you, his muscles won't hurt when he goes to bed tonight. He's going to feel really good. Thank you. I'm going to let you sit for a few moments. I might come after you. Say thank you to him. was ministering the whole time. God was using him the whole time that we were walking around. And it wasn't just a matter of where we stopped. It was God was using him to release what God was wanted to happen in this building. And we need to move in the mood of the Spirit, not just what we think we like. Because if we always think it has to be a certain way, we'll definitely move into the spirit of poverty. And we don't want to do that. We want to be so mobile that we can be moved by his eye, right? Right. So that he can say, take a breath, and we take a breath. There's so much more that God has planned for all of us. So much more that's happening in the Spirit. And he does not want us to be ignorant of what's happening in the Spirit. Can you say that with me? He doesn't want me to be ignorant of what's happening in the Spirit. Because that's the realm that we live in. We live in his kingdom. And so the worldly kingdom is not too healthy for us. We're going to walk in the Spirit. So you can go to Galatians 5. You can read Galatians 5 and see where we're supposed to walk, how we're supposed to walk, what the fruit of the Spirit is. And that's what God wants to manifest in us, is the fruit of the Spirit, because that's his character, the fruit of the Spirit. That's his character. And that's what he is up to, is to move us into that so that we can touch a world that's lost, so that we can minister to people who are not knowledgeable about what it is that we walk in the kingdom. But we have hungry people out there. They just don't know what they're hungry for. Just like when you come in, what are you hungry for? What do you want? Stand up, Tina. What do you want? What do you really want? Do you just want God to come along and just pat you on the head and say, good boy, good boy, good boy? I just love you, Glenn. Good boy, good boy. No, that's not what it's about. He says, I'm going to use you. I'm going to stand you on your feet, and sometimes you're going to feel like you're turned upside down and backwards, but I still will be the one that's in control, the Lord, control of what is happening in you. And some of the things that are of the past, some of the things that you've held on to, he's going to just shake them right out of you. It won't hurt, but it will feel funny. And you'll wonder, who am I now? And God says, now let me teach you as to who you are now. My handmaiden, my bride, my one that I love, my instrument in the kingdom, my song to the body of Christ. That's who you are. And those things that you have hidden in your heart, they're not hidden to God. They're not. Because he has placed in your heart some great exploits that he says, I want you free so that you can move. And these great exploits for my glory, for the kingdom, for the blessing of the body of Christ. I bless that to you in Jesus' name. Yeah. It's a good thing. Come here, I'm going to hug you. And that's what you'll do. You'll take time to hug the desperate, the destitute, the lost, those that have no idea who they are. And then you'll be able to say, this is what God says that you are. So we call forth that revelation in Jesus' name. and we break everything that has created a barrier to that revelation right now, in Jesus' name. And you're in agreement with me, so it's going to come forth. It's going to come forth. A prophetic anointing is resting on you. And I just loosed it, wild woman, in Jesus' name. Everybody say, wild woman. Freedom. When we get to step into what God is calling us to, there's just so much release there, so much refreshing. There's such a peace to walk in what God has called us to. I really do have a lesson. You notice I just changed the subject again. Yeah. How many are in here under the age of 25? That means come up here, please. This way, facing me. See, when you get as old as the hills like I am, you're not afraid to give an order. Besides, we spent 20 years in the military, so I mean, it just comes easy to give an order, to give a call, to say, hey, you're called. You want to stand right there? Thank you. You want to move a little closer to him? You guys are too far apart. You want to move a little closer? This is what the body of Christ should look like. Just moving in. You're only 25 and you have all that gifting. Oh my gosh, I can't wait until you're 80 like me. I won't be here, but it'll. Wow. Come on, you're backing away. Come on. This is what God called the body to be. You're a little, he doesn't bite, I hope. This is what God called the body to be, shoulder to shoulder, arm to arm. You've got your hands on your hip. He's called all of you to be mighty, mighty weapons in the body of Christ. You thought I was going to say soldiers. Well, I meant that too. But you're weapons against the enemy. You are going to be used to scatter the enemy's devices. You're going to be used to sing the song of the Lord that creates a place where the enemy cannot enter. You're going to be like a wall against the enemy as you move closer and closer together. As you decide that it isn't about your ministry, it is about God's ministry, and that he's going to use his facet that's in each one of you to accomplish what he wants to accomplish. He's going to release a spirit of revelation, revealed knowledge, understanding, into each one of your spirits. And you're going to find out who you really are in Christ Jesus if you ask. If you ask. You have not because you ask not. And so I'm going to encourage you, and I'm going to say to you, start asking, not just for the simple, easy things that you do in your flesh or that are worldly, but ask for the supernatural, spiritual things of Christ Jesus, of the Holy Spirit, to start ministering in. You're going to have a great street ministry. You're going to stand out on the street and call them in. That may not be literal. It will be in your prayer life, but it will be literal at times. You're going to go into many countries in the days that are ahead and bring the Spirit of the living God to those that are lost, those that have been destroyed by their ways of life. You have a hunger for the more of God. You have a hunger that's deep to know God. And God is going to reveal himself in the days to come in different ways. And it's not going to be like you think. So don't push it away, but receive it. Because you cannot put God in a box. So let him out of your box. Let him out. Because he will use you in mighty ways as long as you don't box him in. Take a breath. Okay, I heard that. He heard that. Take a breath. Just breathe. Why do we do that? Those are cleansing breaths. Those are breaths that say, yes, I'm letting you in and I'm pushing out the old. Yeah. That evangelistic gift is really strong on you. I bless that. That's a mama's blessing, but he blesses it too, so that's a papa's blessing. So, right? So would you walk with me and just lay hands on them and each one of them, and we don't even have to do much, but just lay hands on them. Yeah. Yes. Hear the drum beat in his body? Did you hear the sound of the drum in him? Did you hear that? I call that forth. I call it forth. You'll be a man of deliverance. Setting captive after captive after captive free. You'll go into the deep, dark places, but you'll be the light in the deep. Dark places, and you won't fear because you will recognize how strong the Holy Spirit is walking with you. He's going to cause you to be able to know the Word in a way that you have never thought possible.
Mm. Yeah.
Breathe. Breathe. Come on, breathe.
Yeah.
Yeah.
He's opened your eyes. He's going to open your ears. He's going to open your mouth.
I love your agreement. Good. Just by the laying on of hands that he's doing, it's not necessary that we prophesy over each one of you, because the Holy Spirit is going to visit you in your dreams. He's going to visit you at times that you don't think is convenient, and he's going to call you forth. Just keep moving. Actually, he's giving you a father's blessing. Nothing compares with the father's blessing when God has anointed someone to minister it. The Father's blessing. It is a good thing. We're all in agreement out there, right, for the Father's blessing? And do you know, if you need the Father's blessing, just receive it. As he's ministering to these young ones, Just receive that Father's blessing, because it's a needy place in the body of Christ. I didn't ask permission to lay hands on her. I didn't ask her if I could do that. But she trusts me. And that's what you're building in the body of Christ, is so that people can trust you even when they first meet you. because it's Christ in you, the hope of glory, that they're going to trust. That you've come to do them good and not harm. That you've come to encourage and not discourage. Because when we walk in Christ, what we see is what's in the person that Christ has planted and not their weaknesses. Because they're already apprised of their weaknesses. But boy, when you call out the things of Christ that's in them, it's like building a large building of hope. So just putting hands on her, just seeing what God is doing in and through her, just knowing that he's called her, just knowing that the doors are going to be open in this next year for some things that she's been asking for, just knowing that the visitations of the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, actual visitations, are going to be her portion. That she's going to taste and see the goodness of the Lord. She's going to drink from the living waters of the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. And she will serve the Lord all the days of her life. And she will minister in the fields. She will, because God has rested on her. So I bless that to you. I bless that to you. Yeah, and the healing grace is there, and that's your desire. So that's a good thing. Teaching. Oh, but you're going to stir up the body of Christ, and they're going to think, oh, my goodness gracious. So that's going to be a good thing. I bless that to you. I release revelation. I just release that and call it forth. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
The fire of God. Yeah. Come on. It's the fire of God. Hold steady. Just hold steady. It's the fire of God. Yeah. It's the fire of God. I love the fire of God myself. And it doesn't even bother me when people get uncomfortable. It's none of my business how uncomfortable they get. Right? I mean, I'm not going to be mean. We get so worried about, am I going to harm that person? Or am I going to cause them to stumble? You're just not that smart. We're just not that smart. We cause ourselves to stumble. Can I have your hand, please? On top of mine. Thank you. You're strong, man. Not just physically, but spiritually. Yeah, you're a kingdom man. Wow, yeah, just the brilliance of the fire of the Lord is on you, just that whole brilliance, the fire of the Lord, and he doesn't want you to put that fire out, because it's going to burn brighter and stronger, and you're going to be a mighty man in the hearts of the broken people. Because God's going to use you to go to the broken ones. And he will use you to begin the restoration of their hearts and their minds. And I see in the spirit just how God's going to use you to touch the hearts and the minds, and especially the emotions of those that are broken, both male and female, young and old. But I do see this, that you're going to be a barrier, bring truth and understanding and wisdom
as to how to deal with those that have Alzheimer's. And that God's going to so use you to be able to stay that onslaught of the enemy. And your mind will be clear all the days of your life. Your mind will be sound all the days of your life. And God's going to use you. Use you. He's going to use you up sometimes. You'll help. Yeah. When the emotionally broken come to your house and you say, yeah, come in. We know. We know what God wants to do in your heart. We know how God wants to heal you. We know. And by the way, you know the relatives that you're praying for that are lost? They will be found. God's heard your prayer. And they will come into the kingdom. Because the seeds will begin. And God will use you to disciple. Say that word with me. Disciple them, because they'll come and ask. And so you will minister, the two of you, in discipling not only family, but family's family, neighbors. Yeah, I bless that to you. Amen?
Amen.
Alzheimer's.
Yeah.
Not you, but I mean, you're going to be. I'm not declaring that over anybody. It's just the fact that, well, what time do we, are we through? I don't know what time to what time, so you tell me and I will quit.
Are we through?
No. Oh. Are you through with all of these young people?
Let's let them sit down. Yeah, let's let them sit down. They want to look at you. These people want to see you.
Oh, go sit down.
Let's give them a hand, though. How you doing? You okay? You tired?
Mm-hmm, I'm fine. So it is now our job to encourage them and to hold their arms up. Okay? You saw all of those that were young up here. And so we are what? Our commission is, we all think it's to win the lost, but what were we commissioned to do? Disciple. That's our commission. Yes, we're going to win the lost through the knowledge and the wisdom of the Holy Spirit, but it takes some tenacity, some heart, to disciple people, to do that. And the young man that was walking with me, God was discipling him right there to begin to be free to do what God's called him to do, to be obedient and not to wait to check it out and see if it's okay. Okay. There's this beautiful woman in the back. You're all beautiful, but I'm picking on this one woman that's back here. I'm coming to you, honey. Can you come out here and play with me? You got a song, 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 song deep in your heart. You have music all over you. It's just like watching you. It's just like seeing all these notes flying around and all of these horns going. And, you know, it's all over you. It's all over you. I don't know what you do, but I know what you are. And I'm going to ask you to start singing in a greater way all the Psalms. All of them. That God will have such a breakthrough. He is so enamored with your voice. And these little fingers that will play more than one instrument. Which one do you want to play first? Which one do you play first? There. Uh-huh. And the keyboard and the guitar. All of those are in your future. And as you play and as you sing, there will be the grace of healing that comes forth. But greater than that, well, there's nothing greater than that, but there is a lot more. Take a breath. God will open the doors for you to sing. In ways that you've never thought possible. And you're going to have offers in the future. And you just ask God which one. Don't just take the first or the second thing that you think might look right, but ask God. Because God's in charge of your future. And your future is in His hands. But it's a great future. And you'll sing prophetically over people. In fact, we're going to do that. Are you brave? Well, you are now. There's an anointing on you to really be, Would you be embarrassed to do that? Too bad. Come here, let me hug you. If we don't pull it out, where's it going to go? Yeah, if we don't just say, come on, let's move into it. Yeah, you are prophetic, not pathetic, prophetic. You're a mighty woman in the kingdom, and it's a heart's desire, your heart's desire, to move and to be moved. So I'll take you to a safe place, okay? Can you walk with me to a safe place? She looks pretty safe. Do you know each other?
No.
Oh, good. That makes it all the much better. Could you just put, what's your name?
Fiona.
Of course you are. You just look different than you did today. My mind. This is Fiona. This is?
Annette.
Okay, she really is safe. I promise you that. Could you put your hand on her shoulder there? Okay. God's just going to give you some words. Just sing it. She has that gift too. You don't have to make it up or worry about it. Just sing the first word.
So beautiful to Him. Yes, you are. You're everything He's ever wanted. You're everything He needs. You so beautiful to Him.
And wow, it's right.
All of those beautiful sounds that come out of this lovely little girl. Isn't that fun? Isn't that our job? I see your hand. Oh, you want sung over. You want a song. Get your little self up here. Put your hand. I love it. Put your hand on his shoulder.
Okay. You're a mighty man, a mighty man of valor. You're a mighty man. What a mighty man you are. You're a mighty man, a mighty man of valor. Mighty, mighty you are.
Yeah, don't run away. She's got more.
Why stop?
Let's do it. Let's keep going.
Put your hand on his shoulder because you have more. You stop.
Is it the same song?
You think God's going to repeat himself? Oh, no, you're full. Let it out.
Just don't hold back.
You are blessed. You are blessed. Yes, you are blessed. I've blessed you from the womb. I've blessed you today, always and forever. You are blessed.
You are blessed. Supernatural gifting of God.
I'm blessed by this song.
Stand back.
Let's give God a clap. That was really good. It's the body of Christ working, isn't it? You're not finished. We got to get it working, you know? So that you will continue to let it work. Because God's got a place for you. See that man back there? Which man do you think it is? Oh, it's all right. I'm going to take you. Could you please stand up? Because she's going to sing over you. She's going to lay her hand on your shoulder. And
everything is going to be okay. Everything's going to be all right. He's working it out. He's working it out. He's working it out for your good. He says, trust him and you'll see the miracles he will work. Just trust him, trust him, and you'll see.
Amen. Amen. Good job. I'm so proud of you. Aren't you proud of her? So. You want to give her a father's blessing?
All right. You can do it. That was great.
Thank you.
He's just a pastor.
Release, release all that I've given you. Release, release all inside of you. Release, release, release.
Wow. Okay. Fire on you. Take it all. Take it all.
besides it. Where'd he go? Did he leave?
Back here. More fire. More fire. That's it. Just take it. Take the fire. He kept turning fire.
Yes, she is a ball of fire. It's your turn.
For who?
You can. She just got the Father's blessing. But you can see. You're going to see prophetically. Mm.
Rivers, living water, flowing in your veins. The waves are crashing over you, over you. Faithfully, faithfully. Firefall.
That's it.
Firefall.
Yeah, I saw fire.
Wave after wave. Wave after wave. As his love saturates your heart. Wave after wave. Wave after wave. Let it flow out of you. Rushing waters. Rushing waters. Take a hold of the promises he has for you. He says, I got it. I got it. Just take my promises. Take my promises, daughter. Oh, I've loved you from beginning. There is no end. There is no end. Let me love you. Let me love you. He's a good, good father.
You think you're through? We're going to just do one more thing that between the two of you. Is that all right? We're going to do it anyway, so. Really, really, let me look. Yeah, you with the scarf around your neck. That scarf. That's the one. What's your name? Beck. I knew that. It just slipped my mind. Pray for Alzheimer's not to touch me. Okay, this is what I'm going to ask you to do. And this is all part of the hunger thing. I'm going to ask you to put your hand on her and start prophesying in song. And you're going to join in, give each other breaks. So ask the Lord. And do you mind if he puts his hand on you? Good, good, good. So I'm going to stand here, and I'm going to ask you to start.
There's a joy in you. There's a joy in you. It's a deep joy, and he loves your joy. I see the joy, it's exploding, it's exploding in you.
Let it out. Let it out. You've held it in. Just let it out. Then let them fill you with the joy. And run for your dreams. Run fast. Yeah. Run for those dreams God has given you. Just wait and see. Just wait and see.
Good job, both of you. Activation is, it's good stuff, isn't it, sweetheart? Yeah, she needs a hug. Activation is really important if you're hungry, is to allow God to activate you. Yeah, there's a few people in here, but God is anxious to get you activated in the giftings that you have. If they were to minister for any length of time, they would become so strong in that prophetic that it would be just like the Holy Spirit pouring in, and they'd hear the voices of the Lord, the voice of the Lord, and the Holy Spirit would be instructing them just how to go between each other and how to release. And pretty soon what you would see is an explosion in the inside of the person that they're ministering to, a place where God has just pushed out everything that's restrained that person and pouring in life, his life into them. So it's important that we learn how to minister together. Thank you both very, very much. I am so proud of you. Yes. Your telephone's going to ring. Actually, we're finished. You know, if we go any further, it's going to be under your desire for it, but also there would be a press that's not necessary. And we don't want to go to that place. So I'll give you a scripture real quick that I was supposed to. I have it right here. Yeah, So go read Isaiah 55.
Listen, one thing that you can do in these kind of meetings, these are unusual meetings, is because the Holy Spirit's here. Uh-huh. So you can, you're experiencing the presence of the Holy Spirit, which means he's not done, but she's done. So he's not done, but she's done. So then if I were you, because she didn't pray for me, I would just say, Holy Spirit, why did you bring me tonight? What do you want to say to me? Then everybody gets something. So one of the things about meetings, of course, you guys know this if you've been to any length of meetings, is that the whoever's speaking or ministering usually doesn't pick up but a small sampling of who's in the room. But he doesn't do it because those are his favorites, because we're all his favorites. He gives a foretaste so we'd have a taste for, which makes us all hungry. So we all begin to ask and say, God, what about me? That's not selfish at this point. That's appropriate. Lord, what about me? It's the right question. What do you want to say to me, God? What do you want to do with my life right now? Whoa.
It's okay.
I guess I am getting something out of this. But anyway, we have a few minutes where you can come say hi to Mama Tina before she has to go. But God bless you guys. Thank you for coming. And I'm just going to close in prayer, okay?
Let me see.
Oh, go for
please.
It.
I do. I just want to say thank you. Everything that was prophesied, if it had a place in your spirit, lay hold of it. Because God just didn't give to one. So everything that witnessed to your spirit that you thought, oh, that's me, begin to declare it, receive it, and then activate it. Activate it. Let God move in you, in that place. No one is going to leave this place without God having done something in you. And the one thing that he did the most was brought joy. Every one of you experienced joy tonight.